Careblazer, when we think about dementia, we typically think about the brain, memory loss, genetics. But what if I told you that what's happening in your mouth is also important for what's happening in your brain? New research has discovered that the bacteria in your mouth could either help or hurt your brain. In fact, one massive study on oral health found that people with gum disease have a higher risk of developing Alzheimer's disease. Every missing tooth is equivalent to about a 1.1% increased chance of developing dementia. And overall, poor oral health is linked to a 21% increase in developing dementia. One way to think about it is you can consider our mouth like a bustling city. There's some good that's happening in the city, and there's some bad that's happening in the city. The bad bacteria triggers inflammation. It also increases brain decline. Good bacteria helps your brain by producing nitric oxide. And this nitric oxide helps keep the blood going to the brain, which is going to be super important for learning, focus, attention, memory. But if the bad bacteria starts to take over, it starts to negatively impact the brain and starts to speed up dementia progression. These studies are finding really cool things, one of them being very obvious: taking care of our oral health will actually help protect your brain and reduce your risk of dementia. This is the basic stuff. This is like flossing and brushing your teeth. Some ideas for you and your loved one are to do it together, make it fun, and flossing is important. It removes a lot of the bad bacteria. Brushing and flossing our teeth is technically like a dementia defense plan. Another thing a lot of people don't realize is that food can benefit oral health, which is going to impact in our brain as well. But food impacts our mouth bacteria. So we want to eat food that would be considered like nitric oxide superstars. Think green power: spinach, kale, arugula, beets and beet juice, citrus, pomegranate. I know some of these things don't sound quite so appetizing. Maybe consider throwing some of these ingredients in a smoothie can be helpful ways to get them. Make sure we're prioritizing regular dentist visits so that they can catch anything and make sure we get a good cleaning. I know that can be particularly difficult when somebody has dementia, but there are some dementia-friendly dentists, even mobile dentists, could be something to explore, but also Careblazer for you. Okay, now here's where the science gets really interesting. The earlier we catch dementia, the more power we have in being able to do lifestyle interventions, be able to slow down the progress, right? The earlier we catch it, not only can we do those things, but we might even qualify for certain medications and treatments we don't qualify for when the dementia is further progressed. We might be able to get into clinical trials. So much more is available the earlier we catch the disease. But it can be quite hard to catch the disease early on because the changes might be subtle. There's lots of appointments. The paper pencil testing isn't always so obvious. Many, many reasons why catching the disease early on can be complicated. But what scientists are believing, based on this new research, is that by monitoring the level of bacteria in the mouth, they are able to predict the people who are going to develop Alzheimer's disease, at least be able to predict the people who are at very high risk for developing the disease. They're also looking into whether reducing the bad bacteria but giving the mouth more good bacteria can also help reduce or prevent dementia. It's still new, but this is one of the breakthrough new research happening on prevention. Another thing that can be helpful to consider with a doctor's input would be considering probiotics or prebiotics. These can interact with their current medication, so we always want to talk with the doctor and make sure we don't start anything on our own. That can be helpful as well. Okay, here's the deal. If you made it this far in the video, you're 95% ahead of the game compared to most people who don't realize that what is happening in our mouth is actually impacting our brain as well. Now, I've linked several full research articles on this science below in the description. I've also linked a way for you to sign up for our Dementia Dose newsletter, which is the best place to get up-to-date dementia information, caregiving tips, support, and inspiration, all for free every single week. Now, here's what I'm really curious about. Will you change anything based on this video? Is there anything you're going to start doing or stop doing after watching this video? I'd love to know in the comments. I'm also going to link an old video I did about when to go through with health procedures and when not to. At some point, Careblazer, I imagine the dental care and hygiene will become so incredibly challenging. And this video is not made to make you think you have to have your loved one do all of the best perfect oral hygiene and care. I realize that's going to be hard, if not impossible, for some cases, especially in the severe stages. So please remember, we're not here about perfection. We're here about progress and making small steps. And if this might not be possible for your loved one with dementia, I know this is possible for you. Taking care of our own oral health is going to take care of our brain as well. I hope this helps you. I'm sending you so much love. All right.
Also, Nico gets a belly rub for every person who subscribes from this video. So if you haven't already, click the red subscribe button. It's totally free. And Nico says, thank you very much.